Morning, Ron.
Good morning, Mr. Brown.
Thank you, everyone. All right, so today we're looking at the shorter way of addressing these problems. So sometimes a question like this in waste will only work like 6 or 7 months. It takes a bit of effort to write it out like we did before in that sort of extended manner. But once we get more confident, it's easy to see the relationships. So as we said before, the first thing we always want to do is find that field that relates to everything on the table. And as we said before in the last lesson, it was going to be the pet ID because the owner has a pet and the pets have procedures. So it's the one field that links everything together. So let's draw that out. So let's start over here and we have a pet. Then I like to look at the other information and the repeating fields, because that was what we did in the first normal form. So let's look at those. And you can see there that it's going to be procedure. And we can just break up the fields. Okay. If we have another look, I might leave that vacant. See that within pet there's owner, and that it can change depending on the animal, and it's going to be separated out. It's going to be its own entity, so we're going to have owner over here. Now, there's a reason why I left this blank square or blank entity. If we look at our pet, and we've got procedures, so you can see here I have this one pet. I'll look at the procedures over here, and there are many. So I can deduce that I have the one pet. And it's going to have many procedures. If I look at it the other way around, I have a procedure here, rabies vaccination here, I have it again here as well. And you can see that those two procedures, or that one procedure, happens to two pets. So here's my many, here's my one, and over here I've got the many pets of Morris and Rover and I. And I can draw that relationship. Right. So those who might have had an understanding of composite keys, I can't have a many-to-many relationship in a database, they don't work. So what I've done to resolve that is I've made this composite key, and I'll just call it pet visit. Keyword you always want, like details in ERD, is has. So one procedure has many pet visits. One pet has many pet visits. Can't go wrong with has as your relationship. Now, let's look at the owner. So you can see here I've got one owner. And if you go here, I also have two pets. So therefore, one owner, many pets. And that's the basic ERG. Just by looking at the data, and having a knowledge of normalization, I can then isolate each entity out. Now, if we look at Chen's notation, there is specific method of writing down each field. So let's go through that. Right, so we draw bubbles. I always like to start off with the primary key. It has owner name. Name's not unique, so we have to create our own primary key. I'm going to call it owner ID. And then we'll have owner name. head ID. Head name. Head type. Head age. And we've got pet visit. So we can see there we've got the M and the two M's going in there. So that means there's going to be two foreign keys involved in our composite key. Let's start out over here. We'll have a primary key first, which was pet visit ID. Make sure you have the FK foreign key, procedure, ID, because that's the one we created, last lesson, we broke them apart, and FK, and then we have the visit date. And that's included because it involves the pet itself and also when that procedure can be done or completed. And the last part is the procedure itself. Let's go out this way. That was the procedure ID. Let's just make sure we've got everything here. So, pet ID, pet name, pet type, pet age. Yes, yes, yes. We've got the owner, yep. We have visit dates here, procedure, number, so your name. Yeah, we've got all the foreign keys, yes.
No.
Yes. There's no owner foreign keys, so that can be double checked.
Primary keys are underlined as well.
So always good to double check your diagrams. So you don't make some easy mistakes. And we need to underline. Yes, this is the underline here. Because we lose marks on finding the primary key. And I'll just clean this up a bit here. Alright, good. And so you can see that if I had to draw out the EID using chance notation, I didn't have a lot of time, but I could look at the data and make conclusions on their relationships. This will happen with practice, but you can also attempt the extended form as well, which gives you a better understanding of the relationship between datas and when to break up entities and when not to. Thanks for your time. Any comments? We're going to flip forward. Thank you.